Nicole and Jonathan first asked me to officiate for them, I was terrified. They share something so special, a bond so strong and so unique. How on earth was I going to turn something that intangibly beautiful into words? So naturally, I turned to the internet for answers. I find myself watching countless wedding videos, reading through scores of wedding ceremonies, talking to my married friends, getting in touch with their priests, ministers, pastors, little brothers. But nothing I watched seemed right. It just wasn't perfect. And then one night during my search, I stumbled across an old Friends episode, the one with Phoebe's wedding. And it was then that I finally figured it out. And no, ironically enough, it wasn't the wise words of Reverend Joey Tribbiani that struck a chord with me. As I sit there in my apartment in California, I remember the house I grew up in Connecticut. Our playroom, Nick and Sam on one couch, Mom and Dad on the other, me and Luke on the floor, and Friends on the TV. It was one of the few times that we were all together. No one was at work or school. It was too late to go outside and play. No one got up to go on AIM, push through another load of laundry, or go play video games in the other room. We smiled, we laughed, Mom cried. We bonded as a family. And that was it. I finally realized that it doesn't matter what I say up here today, because the perfect ceremony for Nicole and Jonathan is one with all of you here, their family, and their friends. So, whether you've traveled a few miles or a few thousand miles to be here today, thank you so much. Words cannot express how much it means to Nicole and Jonathan and to me. You've definitely made my job. So, today we're celebrating the coming together of Nicole and Jonathan. I remember the first time I met Jonathan back in 2008 at Nicole's graduation. He was terrified that my siblings, my parents and I would find out that he was incredibly hungover from the night before. If only he knew that 6.5 years later I'd be telling the story at his wedding. Needless to say, my entire family fell in love with him that day. He was charming, smart, and he brought out something in Nicole that none of us had ever seen before. He made her happy, sure, but there's something more. Something that was impossible to describe, but even more impossible to overlook. And since then, the years that followed have brought nothing but the same. Countless nights sitting at our kitchen table, Jonathan seamlessly integrating into our family dynamic. And I cannot wait to call him my brother-in-law. I wish words existed that could capture how truly incredible she is. As a sister, a daughter, a friend, and a soon-to-be wife. She has this selflessness about her that I've never seen in anyone before. This is actually a story that she doesn't know. So, one night this past summer, I was having a really lousy night sitting alone in my apartment, and I found myself reading through a letter I wrote her a year earlier. It's basically a letter just saying, thank you so much for being so wonderful and so sweet and so kind and so supportive. I was halfway through that letter and my phone rang. It was Nick. Mind you, this was 11:30 p.m. California time, so you can only imagine the state she was in back in Rhode Island. I'll save you the details, but the gist of the phone call was that she just wanted me to know that she loved me and she supported me, always and forever. It was an affirmation that couldn't have been less necessary, but at the same time, couldn't have been more serendipitously appropriate. She always has her loved ones on her mind, and I know that she's going to make Jonathan the happiest and the luckiest man in the world. I'm now going to ask Leah to come up and read a poem that Nicole and Jonathan picked out that really embodies why we're here today.
I'm going to be reading Somewhere I Have Never Traveled by E.E. Cummings. Somewhere I have never traveled, gladly beyond any experience, your eyes have their silence. In your most frail gesture are things which enclose me, but which I cannot touch because they are too near. Your slightest look will easily unclose me, though I have closed myself as fingers. You open always, petal by petal, myself as spring opens, touching skillfully, mysteriously, her first rose. Or if your wish be to close me, I and my life will shut very beautifully, suddenly, as when the heart of this flower imagines the snow, carefully ever descending. Nothing which we are to perceive in this world equals the power of your intense fragility, whose texture compels me with the color of its countries, rendering death and forever with each breathing. I do not know what it is about you that closes and opens, only something in me understands. The voice of your eyes is deeper than all roses. Nobody, not even the rain, has such small hands.
No. Julia, that's beautiful. No. If you haven't guessed already, Nicole and Jonathan aren't very religious in the traditional sense of the word. This wedding isn't happening in a church. I'm certainly not a priest. But as per the poem that Leah just read, it's not hard to see that they have a taste for beautiful words, no matter the origin. So on that note, I'd like to introduce a few more passages. Bernie and Sarah, you could join me up here.
Love is patient, love is kind.
It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud.
It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs.
Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth.
It always protects, always hopes, always perseveres.
Love never fails.
Thank you. That was a letter to the Corinthians, and this is an ancient Apache lesson.
Now you will feel you will be shelter for each other.
Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth for the other.
Now there is no more loneliness, for each of you will be the companion to the other.
Now you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you.
Go now to your dwelling place. Go now to your dwelling place to enter into the days of your togetherness.
May your days together be good and long upon the earth.
Thank you. Last but not least, Luke.
Standing quietly by the fence, your smile, your wondrous smile. I am speechless, and my senses are filled by the sounds of your beautiful song. Beginningless and endless, I bow to you deeply.
Thanks, Luke. Now these passages, just like everyone present today, have no single origin, no common root. They come from different cultures, different centuries even. But they, like us, are all united today by the love between Nicole and Jonathan. I'd like to ask that everyone in the audience stand. Nicole and Jonathan, please turn and face them. You are the foundation upon which they will start to build their new life together. Your wise words will guide them through the dark times, and your smiles and laughter will make the good shine that much brighter. Always stand beside them, never between. Offer them an ear to listen, a shoulder for support, a hand to hold. Encourage them when needed, and offer advice when asked. I now ask you, will you do all in your power to support this marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
Thank you. Please be seated. Nick and Jonathan, you have the resounding support of your closest friends and family. You have chosen this beautiful venue on this beautiful New England day to consummate your eternal bond. And I know I speak for everyone when I say that this day could not have come soon enough. I cannot imagine two people who are more right for each other. Two people more perfectly matched, whose strengths and weaknesses align exactly out of phase, one effortlessly picking up the other at the first sight of a stumble. I love you both so much, and I cannot wait to watch you embark on this new journey together. Now, Nick, you could repeat after me.
I, Nicole, take you to be my best friend. My better half, my husband, to have and to hold from this day forth. In seasons of Red Sox victories, may there be many, and Patriots losses, may there be few. For richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us
part. And Jonathan, have you heard me?
I, Jonathan, take you, Nicole, to be my best friend, my better half, my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward. In exclamations of yipper skippers when the good times roll. In exclamations of expletives when they do not. For rich or for poor, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
Good job. Thank you both. The giving of rings is a tradition that transcends cultures and religions. A perfect circle representing a never-ending bond between two people. Sean, can I have the rings? Jonathan, take this ring, place it on Nicole's finger.
With this ring, I give you a piece of me. So even when we are apart, you will never walk alone.
Nick, please take this ring, put it on Jonathan's finger, and repeat after me.
With this ring,
I give you a piece of me. So even when we are apart, you will never walk alone.
Nicole and Jonathan, you have pledged your love for each other, exchanged promises, and given each other rings that symbolize your union. So, by the power vested in me by the state of Massachusetts and ordainmeplease.com, it is my greatest honor and privilege to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Yeah.